Hello friends, welcome to Technique. This is Nirmal here, and in this video we're going to do a review of a powerful gaming laptop under the ROG series. We have the ROG Strix G15. Now this is announced, the 2021 edition, announced with the Ryzen 9 5900HX variant. It's a powerhouse. Literally it comes up to with 16 gigs of RAM. You can expand up to 32 gigabyte RAM. It has RTX 3070 with up to 8 gigabyte RAM, and then you get either 512 GB SSD or 1 TB SSD. Then it's a really powerful device with QHD display with 165 Hz refresh rate and 3 millisecond response time and a great battery life too. So we're going to talk about this laptop. So we'll just show you this laptop. You can see it's a really big, powerful laptop for gamers. So it's not just a laptop for gamers alone. It's a really powerful laptop with the top of the line hardware. So it can also be used as a creator's laptop with a great display as well. So we'll be talking about that perspective more than gaming. We all know that ROG laptops are meant for gaming, but we'll be talking more about our usage, that as a creator, we use heavy applications like the Premiere Pro and also Photoshop, and lot of heavy memory consuming tasks. So we'll be reviewing from that perspective, how good is this laptop for this price segment of it. It's actually a premium laptop in all aspects. It's literally a powerhouse. We have been using this for almost like 2.5 weeks now. We have actually shifted our complete work to this laptop to get a complete experience. We have been doing editing on this laptop, literally everything, our day-to-day task on this laptop, and this is our impressions on this powerhouse. So let's get started. But before that, if this is your first time on the channel, do hit that subscribe button and also hit the bell icon to get notified of all the videos we publish. So let's begin. So first, let's have a look at the design and build quality of this premium laptop. So first thing, what you notice about the ROG Strix G15 is a striking pink bar on the corner, which is actually the Electropunk edition, the 2021 edition. And it's actually a refreshing change to the design. It actually looks good. It actually pretty neatly blends into the black design. Now it's a completely matte finish design. There is an RGB, LED RGB light under the chassis, which gives it a great feel altogether, especially for gamers. And this is fairly lightweight for a gaming laptop. It's just 2.3 kilograms, and the bezels of the display are really good. Although it's a 15 inch laptop, it has been made compact with a smaller bezels on the side panel. Now the chassis is made out of aluminium, and it has a unibody matte finish, a completely matte finish. And you can also see that ROG typography on top of the keyboard layout, which actually blends neatly into the overall design elements. Now if you look at the display aspect, you can see that the display bottom bezel are made into a different pattern. This actually helps in improving the heat dissipation of the laptop, so it neatly blends in the design. Now the display bezels on three sides are completely minimalistic. As a result, you can see that the webcam has been skipped. The bottom bezel is slightly on the higher side, but again, as I said before, it looks really good in terms of design aspect. You also get the ROG Strix branding. Now the keyboard layout is a full-fledged keyboard layout with RGB lighting. The bottom section also comes with the RGB lighting, as I said before. Now the trackpad is a large trackpad, and that actually helps in the overall look and feel of the use and also the usage of the trackpad. Now you can also see that the back panel has the ROG logo. You can also see that some ROG elements embedded on the back panel. You can also see that heat vents are kept on either side of the laptop and also the behind. Now the bottom section is something quite impressive. You can see that even the build quality looks really good. Although it's made of plastic at the bottom section, it feels really nice. So overall, it's one of the well-built premium laptops for gamers. So overall, we like the look and feel and how the aesthetics are blend together. That's what makes this laptop kind of unique at this price segment, especially with the Electropunk edition, which gives it a pink accents to the corner with the black. So that merges pretty well in the laptop. So design and build quality is really good on this laptop. Next, let's move on to the ports and connectivity. So being a gaming laptop, ports and connectivity are very important aspects. You need a really good number of ports for connecting your mouse and other accessories. So how good it is, let's find out. So on the left side, you get two USB type A port. It's a USB 3.2 Gen 1 port. Two of them are on the left side. There is also 3.5mm audio jack included. And the back section of the laptop has the charging port. Then you also get the regular RJ45 port, the jack for connecting your LAN cables. Then you get an HDMI port included, HDMI 2.0 port. Then we have one USB Type-C port. It's a USB 3.2 Gen 2 port. It supports display port as well as 100 watt power delivery is also supported. Then also you get another USB 3.2 Gen 1 Type-A port. So there are three USB Type-A ports. On the right side, you don't get any ports. Rather, you get the heat dissipation areas. Now, the heat dissipation is available on either side and also on the back panel. So there is adequate vents included on this laptop. Next, let's move on to the display. So one of the important things for a gamer or even for a content creator is how good the display performance is. Now this device, the ROG Strix G15, comes with two display options. One is a full HD resolution panel with a 300Hz refresh rate and 3 millisecond response time. The another variant, the one we have, is a QHD panel similar to the Zephyrus G14 reviewed last year. This comes with a 165Hz refresh rate. Last year it was the regular refresh rate, but here we get 165Hz refresh rate, again 3 millisecond response time. Now the display quality is one of the superb panels we have seen on this device. So it actually feels really good, especially for content creators. We have been editing videos on this laptop and we felt that the display quality is one thing which is really good on the in terms of overall experience. The panel is really bright, great colors, and it's blazing fast in terms of performance. When you use the panel, you can actually feel how fast it is in terms of response time, and the higher refresh rate makes up for great experience altogether. Even for watching movies, this is a great display out there. Apart from that, the color reproduction is also really good on this laptop. We have been editing videos on this laptop using Adobe Premiere Pro, and we could get really good colors. Now, one thing about this laptop is that you can see that the razor thin bezels means that you have to compromise on the webcam. So there is no integrated webcam included on this laptop, but what Asus has done is provided a bundled webcam in the box package, so you can use it with the USB port, and the webcam quality is actually quite good. So it doesn't come with a webcam built in, but you can use a webcam which is bundled in the box package. Now next, let's move on to the performance and software aspect. Now this device is powered by the Windows 10 Home Edition, and this the one variant which we have is the powered by the Ryzen 9 5900HX, and this has the RTX 3070 GPU, the NVIDIA GPU, which is a really powerful one for this laptop series, and this has up to 1 TB of hard disk option available. The one we have is 1 TB. There is also 512 GB of SSD included, and you also get the Wi-Fi 6 and Bluetooth options included. So that's the hardware aspect. Now you can also expand the RAM. This is 16 gigs of RAM available on this laptop, the one we reviewed. You can also expand it to 32 gigabyte RAM. So let's have a look at some of the performance aspect. In terms of day-to-day experience, Ryzen 9 5900HX is one of the best AMD chipsets available right now. It has 8 cores, 16 threads, and it is actually unlocked and overclockable, but that you don't really need to overclock it because this is even a powerhouse as such. Now in terms of heat dissipation, last year when we reviewed the Zephyrus G14, the heating was kind of very much higher because it was a 14 inch laptop and the heat dissipation was not very well controlled. But this one, the heat dissipation is really, really well controlled, and you don't actually feel any sort of heat happening in the keyboard. While last year when we reviewed the Zephyrus G14, the keyboard actually heats up a lot over a period of time. But this one, even with intensive tasks like editing 4K videos, 4K 60fps videos, and even using Photoshop simultaneously, there was absolutely no heating issues. Here are some of the synthetic benchmark scores for the ROG Strix G14 in case you are interested in the synthetic benchmark scores. The with 16 gigs of RAM and the Ryzen 9 5900HX and the NVIDIA 3070 GPU. This is really a powerhouse, and even for gamers, you definitely love using this laptop, especially with a great display and a powerful processor. So we had no issues whatsoever using this laptop in terms of our day-to-day usage. Now, in terms of other aspect, you get the Aura Sync option, which you can customize the RGB lighting. The RGB lighting, as I said before, spreads to the back bottom section, and you also get an RGB lit keyboard. And apart from that, you also get the Armoury Crate application, which is Asus custom software to customize how you want the laptop. There are different modes available: turbo, performance, silent mode. So based on how you want the laptop to perform, you can customize these things. This is all available in the Armoury Crate application, which is a really good implementation of Asus in terms of how you want to manage the performance of this laptop. Now, talking about the keyboard. The keyboard is well-spaced keyboard with RGB lighting. It's a backlit keyboard. You can customize the backlit lighting with the Aura Sync application. And the keypress is simply superb on this laptop. And the overall feedback you get from the keyboard is really good. And we did not see any sort of issues while typing. And you also get some custom keyboard options, keys for media playback as well as for gamers. So it's a well-placed keyboard, and it's a full-fledged keyboard. So typing experience is simply superb on this laptop. Now, you also get a very large trackpad. Again, the trackpad experience is one of the best we have seen on a premium laptop. Hardly any issues, and the touch response from the trackpad is also really impressive. So that's the keyboard and trackpad experience. Now, in terms of speaker experience, you get dual speakers with Dolby Atmos sound support. Again, one of the really good laptops in terms of sound experience. If you look at the overall quality of the sound, it's really impressive. The output is loud, the sound quality is impressive, and for a gaming laptops or even for a multimedia laptop, this is something which is really good. Now, moving on to the battery life. Now, if you look at the battery, now gaming laptops are seldom made for a great battery life. If you look at the ultra portable laptops, you get like 10 or 12 hours of battery life, but gaming laptops are never meant for that. But still, you get a 90 watt hour battery on this, and it's a 240 watt charging brick. Now, the problem with the charging brick is that it's a 16 ampere socket. That means in normal homes, it's very hard to find a 16 ampere socket, especially in your living room or a bedroom. You seldom have 16 ampere sockets, especially for air conditioners or fridges. Otherwise, you don't really use the 16 ampere socket for a regular laptop, but this one ships with a 16 ampere socket. So the problem is, when you're traveling, you have to carry a power delivery charger, because with a 16 ampere charger, you may not be able to charge the laptop. Now, once you remove from the charger, then the laptop goes for the regular refresh rate, and also the GPU does not perform really well. It goes to the inbuilt GPU when the charging is removed. So that's the disadvantage. So if you want to get the complete performance while traveling, you might have to invest on a PD charger. The 100 watt charging is supported by a USB Type-C port, so you have to invest on that. But otherwise, the battery life is quite good. We got like 4 to 5 hours of battery life on this, which is a really impressive thing for a gaming laptop. So again, in our testing, we used a heavy usage, like editing 4K 60 FPS videos, and also editing images on the fly. So a lot of the works we did simultaneously, and the battery life was like 4 to 5 hours. So that's the Asus ROG Strix G15 battery life. Now, summing up, should you buy the ROG Strix G15? Now, the ROG Strix G15, the top-end variant, is not just for gamers. It's definitely a beast for gamers. It's one of the highly performance-oriented laptops we have tested in this year. It's a really a powerhouse. In fact, with any task you throw at it, be it gaming, heavy gaming, or even heavy creators task like video editing, it runs pretty smoothly and does not heat up. A decent battery life, excellent display, great keyboard experience, overall build quality, fit and finish, everything looks really good. Even the sound experience is superb. So it's one of those laptops which gets all the aspects or rather which ticks all the right aspects, and there is hardly anything to complain on this laptop. Coming to the cons of the laptop, the first and foremost one, as I said before, 16 ampere brick for charging. That's something which is definitely not ideal for gamers, especially when you're moving from one place to another. Getting a 16 ampere plug in India might not be a very easy task. Otherwise, this laptop is a powerhouse. But then you also don't get an integrated webcam. But you do get an additional webcam which is provided by the company. And apart from that, there is no Thunderbolt support. That's another, probably one of the cons you can list. But otherwise, it's a really powerful laptop and it performs really well, whatever task you throw at it. So that was a detailed review of the Asus ROG Strix G14. G15, the 2021 edition with the Ryzen 9 5900HX. So that's a detailed review. Hope you enjoyed watching this video. Do hit that like button and also hit the subscribe button for more videos. Thanks for watching. Hope to see you in our next video. Have a great day.